dear children, noble citizens of Thebes, I see you here, gathered around the palace in mourning robes. I have heard your tears, your cries of anguish. You know me. I am Oedipus, your king, and I will do everything in my power to bring you relief. You, sir, tell me, please, what would the people have me do?
King Oedipus, our great sovereign, we gather here, young, old, women and children, parents, but they come by the thousands seeking your aid. Our city dies. Do you not see here in the streets and alleyways? Thebes rots. She is bathed in blood. The harvest bring only dust. Our livestock wither and fall. Babies die in the womb of their mothers and perish by plague or famine. We know you. Great King Fortune favors you. We remember you saved us from the terrors of the monstrous Sphinx. You solved her riddles and brought your genius here to rule over our state. You helped us once before. Don't prevent us now.
Oh, sir, I know how the people suffer. Believe me, I suffer too, more than you know. Day and night, I weep for my city. I have met with my counselors, trying to tease out an answer. I have even sent Creon, the queen's own sister, to the oracle of Apollo. As soon as she returns and shares a prophecy, we will discover what the gods would have us do. And I promise you, all of you, we will carry out their will.
No answer could be better, sire. And look, as if on cue, Creon comes.
Thebans.
Dear sister-in-law, what has the prophecy written? What do the gods demand?
The gods have given us clear answers and a simple command. Something infects our city, something unclean. It was born here, and here it remains. To save Thebes, we must either destroy this abomination or expel it from our lands.
Did the oracle reveal its crimes?
Yes, bloodshed and regicide. Years ago, King Laius, who ruled here before you, was murdered. His killer must be found and brought to justice.
King Laius? That was years ago. Has no one investigated since then? What details do you recall?
Only the reports of one servant, a woman who barely escaped with her life. She told us it happened on Laius' pilgrimage across the country. A gang of robbers took his life.
Highwaymen? Attacking a king? Come now, there must be more to the story than that.
Perhaps, but that she-demon, the Sphinx, kept us in too much terror to search any further.
Well, then, let us reopen the case. Let's find these savages and bring them to justice. Our lost command is to honor the fallen. And besides, these assassins may even strike at me. If we cannot make this injustice right, Thebes will fall. We must not let that happen.
Yes, sire.
Citizens, return now to your homes. We must trust in the king and in the gods to see to the heart of this matter. Pray that they uncover the truth, and swiftly.
Gods of Olympus, grant us grace.
Bowman Apollo, aim your arrows and let them fly. To fight off the fiend who gorges on our grief and grows fat from our tears.
Athena, Artemis, Zeus, the great Sky King, can you not hear our cries, our screams and our laments? Save us now before we slip away into death.
Laius is killed. I had not yet come to Thebes. I cannot solve this crime without your assistance. If anyone here knows the name of this killer, I order you to come forward now. Perhaps it might be one of you. I swear, if you confess now, I will be as lenient as I can in passing sentence. No? Then I pass my judgment on the cutthroat now.
Whoever he is,
He shall never again see friends or relatives or any beloved. No one will take him into their charity. None will eat with him, walk with him, pray with him. May this murderer bear the stain of his crime until he lies dead in the ground. No mercy till the end of his life. I, Oedipus, the favorite of destiny, do make this vow. I curse him, and may the gods pour their curses upon him too.
That curse, my lord, terrifies us all. How can we find the curse or the guilty one? None of us here know him.
There is one who might. The blind woman, who sees more than any other. The prophet, Tiresias. At Creon's suggestion, I sent for her some time ago, hoping she could reveal to us the truth of the ordeal. Tiresias, you know all the secrets of understanding. You see what others cannot. You have returned to your homeland in her hour of need. You must know what the oracle has decreed. The murderers of lies hide here, among us, so we can find and punish them who are doing. Please, use your gifts to save us from our agony.
Oedipus, my gifts can only bring gloom here. My wisdom can bring nothing but greater suffering. I should not have come.
You know the answer, don't you? You won't tell us? Will you let things die?
The truth is far too painful, Oedipus. My secret and yours. Do not waste your time. I will not speak.
You are no prophet. You are a demon. You insult every Theban with your silence.
Lose your temper if you like. The fault lies not with me. I shall tell you nothing.
Yes! I am angry! I brought you here to save my people. Nothing for them. And perhaps with good reason, too. Tiresias the prophet? Tiresias the opportunist! Did you yourself plan this vile crime? Work with brigands for a share of the ransom?
You implicate me? You are a fool.
Oh, I can see the truth clear enough. If you still had your eyesight, you surely have killed lies yourself. That much I know.
Do you indeed? Very well. You provoke me to reveal the truth. The curse you've uttered will fall upon your head. From today, never speak to me or anyone ever again. You are the man. You are the infection that breeds death and plague.
How dare you? Are you saying what I think you are?
You are the murderer of Laius.
Twice. You accuse me in front of the Senate. I will make you regret this, you old fool.
The truth protects me. And what I have yet to say will make you even angrier. She whom you call beloved, she is not what you think. The relationship is perverse, detestable. It will be your undoing.
Oh, you know nothing of the truth. You're blind to it, a prisoner of your own mind.
Even in your fury make me pity, Oedipus. Soon you will hear those same words, spoken with the same rage.
Why should I believe you? Poor, blind old woman. Trapped in the darkness. You can't hurt me.
Not I, great king.
Aha! Now I see it all. It was Creon, after all, who went to the oracle. It was Creon who reminded me of your inspiration in the first place. You mean to overthrow me? Usurp my power? You will both pay for your crimes.
I serve none but the gods. And while you laugh at my blindness, you cannot see what I can, the horrors that await you, great king, the retributions for your sins. You know nothing, nothing of your bride, or your parents, or yourself. Two curses, like father and mother, will eject you from this place and banish you to the wilderness. Every man, woman, and child on this earth will know your shame and torment. All will despise your wretched name.
Take her from this place. She reigns and speaks nothing but lies!
Oh yes, I will go now, but I will make one last prophecy before I do. The man you want, the king killer, is here, in your midst. He pretends to be a foreigner, but Thebes is his homeland. He can see clearly when he arrives, but he will leave blind like me. He will go into exile as a poor beggar with no one to guide him. To his children, he is brother
trust the sage Tiresias? Do we speak our thoughts or do we hold them inside?
One thing remains certain despite all else. If the murderer is not found, our fates are sealed.
By the time the sun sets, he must be banished, or thieves will not live to see the dawn.
Chooses me. She and her fortune teller claim I am the one who murdered the king.
So that's it. Divinations and predictions. My lord, no one can predict the future. Not even the wise Tiresias.
But your castle.
I know this better than anyone. Elias and I were married. We had a son. That foul oracle told us that Elias would be murdered by our own child. Elias was killed by unknown robbers far from here, at the place where three roads meet. As for the child, our sweet baby boy, he was abandoned and unoccupied, taken there by a servant. We had his ankles drilled through and tied together. We had to be sure. We believed the oracle at the time. That prophecy never came true. So why should this one be any different?
Jocasta, something you said, I remember.
What is it? What's wrong?
Did you say that Lys was slain at a place where three roads meet?
Yes, on the way to Delphi.
When?
A short while before you arrived here.
Oh, God. What will you do to me?
Oedipus, why do you look so pale?
No. No. Please don't ask me. Tell me more. Tell me everything you can remember about the day he left. Perhaps Tiresias wasn't so blind after all. Where is this child? Where is the shepherd? Is she here in the city?
No. When she returned, she begged me to be let go, so that peacefully goodbye.
The water here, today. We must send guards to search that mountain and Bring her to me before the sun sets.
Oedipus, why so frightened? Tell me, please.
Oh, my dear wife. I'll tell you everything. You know, I am from court. My father is king there. And I have been raised following his footsteps. And who laughed at him until one day I wanted to discover my own destiny. I went to the work. But I was met with another story altogether. A disgusting, horrifying tale of the future. That I would murder my father and marry my own mother, Mary. I heard this atrocity, I left. Ran away from home as fast as I could. But I came to a place with three roads in it. I saw a stately carriage approaching. The driver shouted at me to get out of the way. I was furious. As the carriage passed by me, the old man inside swatted at me with his staff, so I pulled him from his coach. Beat him to death. The servants attacked me and they killed him too. I couldn't think. I was like an animal. If that man was who I think he was, then no one is more miserable than me. Fate will drive me out into the wilderness, never to see you again. I can never return to Corinth. Fear the Lord's prophecy will come true. Today, I laid my curse on the assassin. Now that curse will linger on me. Perhaps I was cursed from the very beginning.
Listen to me, Oedipus. The shepherd that you have sent for has said that the king was killed by the robbers. If you wait for her return, I know she will explain everything.
Yes. Let's go in. The shepherd arrives, then we shall be. The shepherd arrived.
Better. Polybus has died. Do you see, my love? Your father is dead.
Truly.
Passed away in sleep just last night.
Ha! Oh, what news! No doom awaits me now. So much for the screeching bird songs of that mad woman. Oracle of the gods, indeed.
Oh, my love, didn't I say so from the start?
You did, my darling. Forgive me. I should have listened to you then.
Excuse me? I'm a bit confused, good king. Why so cheerful that Polybus is dead?
Dear friend, please, don't misunderstand. I loved Polybus. We'll miss him dearly. There was a prophecy, a horrible warning. I was destined, so the word was said, to kill my own father and marry my mother.
Oh, my boy, is this what kept you away all these long years?
Well, that should have been reason enough. I didn't want to murder my father.
Listen, my friend, all this time you could have stayed at home. Polybus was not your father, and Merope is not your mother. I brought you to them. They were without child, so they adopted you, raised you as their own.
I was not their son. Who were my parents? Was I sold as a slave, child?
No. You were found here among the Thyrod. I was a shepherd at the time, and it's a good thing I was here, or you might never have survived.
What do you mean?
Your ankles had been pierced and strapped together.
any of you know the shepherd she means, where can we find her?
We believe one you've already sent for, my lord, but the queen will come for sure.
Jocasta, do you remember? Or are these two shepherds the same woman?
What? Oh, one shepherd or another. What does it matter? Please, don't pursue it.
I must. It's hence to figure out the secret of my birth.
Listen to me now. I beg of you, do not go on with this search. It's making me ill. If you continue down this road, you'll be doomed. No escaping the tragedy you'll uncover. Please, promise me now you'll forget it once and for all.
Why this insistence? Oh, I see. She must be afraid my blood isn't royal enough for her after all. Are you scared you married a slave like you?
I have sent all I can, my husband. I shall never see your face again after this day. You're doomed. There's nothing more to say.
Well, let the truth come out. Traveled this far, and now I'm determined to discover my identity. It matters not whether my parents are nobles, slaves, or spirits of the earth and trees. I am what I am. I have no desire to be anyone else. Who am I? That I will know. I must!
Sire!
This must be the woman we've been waiting for. Do you know her?
Yes, the former shepherd of our country.
And you, ma'am, is she also the one you spoke of?
Indeed.
Now, listen to me carefully. Answer my questions honestly, and you may go home. Lie to me, you will pay for it. Do you understand? Did you work for Lucas?
Yes, sir. I was shepherd for a Chiron.
Have you ever seen this woman before?
I reckon so, sire. Ages ago, it seems, your neighbor is working on the mountain.
And do you remember the abandoned child from all those years?
Of course I do. Why bring that up?
Dear friend, this is that child. Well, no longer a child, I should say.
Be quiet, you fool. You don't know what you're talking about.
You know, don't you? You know the truth.
Please, sir, don't make me answer.
I will hear it. Guard, hold her arm behind the back. Tight!
Please, don't hurt me. I'm just an old woman ready for death.
Then answer me now! Did you bring that child to this woman?
I did.
Where did that child come from? Was it your own?
No, I swear. It came.
Tell me, a thieving citizen, a slave family? Whose house, you old fool?
It was born in the house of life.
Was it a relative? I'll take him by blood.
I'm on the edge, sir. Must I say it?
Yes, we're both on the edge now. I must hear it.
It was his own. The queen. She gave him to me, told me to leave him on the mountain.
Why?
A prophecy, sire. They whispered the boy would kill his own father.
And why, in the name of all the gods, didn't you kill the child yourself?
I couldn't do it, my lord! I just couldn't do it. A little boy less than a few weeks old, I thought she'd take it away from here. Far away from here. And now, if you are that same child, then you were marked out for suffering. From the day you were born.
All of it. I know it all now. It all came true. Every single word. My birth, a crime, my wedding, a crime. It's the murder of my own father. I see it all now.
man been brought so low after flying so high? These agonies are beyond telling, but we must endure. Son of our murdering king, despised by the gods, why did you ever return to your home? We weep to see your weary fate, to see you save us with your suffering.
Senators! Demons! I come with news much too terrible to imagine! Horrors beyond telling!
Speak quickly! Share your news with us!
The queen, my lord, she's dead.
How?
She hanged herself. When she came into the palace, she was shouting something about lies and Oedipus and all the manner of vile curses upon herself and her heirs. Then she slammed her door shut. We all heard the screams. And then he came.
The king?
Banged onto her doors until they fell open. And then we saw her slowly spinning like a pendulum in air. I will never forget the sight of that gruesome picture.
What happened then? Where is the king now?
It is almost too awful to tell. He cut her down, carried her to the marriage bed, and laid her on it. With his eyes full of tears, he reached to her dress and pulled from the fabric two gold pins and put out his. He comes now. He says he must be exiled before tomorrow's dawn.
Take me away from this place. Senators, expel me at once! I have been filled with that poisonous thieves, the cause of so much pain. My time to suffer has come at long last.
Behold, the man, once the greatest among mortals, laid so low, brought to darkness by his own hand.
Why have eyes to see when all that remains is horror and suffering? No beauties of theirs can comfort me now. Better to blot out my own vision. How else could I face my own father when I greet them in the underworld?
Your life will be nothing but suffering, misery, exile, banishment, solitude.
And my name will be known forever, until the end of all things. Father killer, mother lover, the cursed one, Oedipus the Great.
All will know, all will remember.
But hush now. Footsteps are those. Do I hear approaching?
I am not here to mock or gloat my brother-in-law, only to take you inside and watch over you until you learn what the gods command.
Creon, I don't understand. Take me in. The oracle has decreed.
We shall determine your fate tomorrow. For now, you must come inside. The Thebans have all gathered here. They should not see you show your grief so publicly.
No. Better to let me depart now. My actions have brought this plague upon this city. My city. Thebans, my children. All this time, I had been so blind to the truth. And now that my eyes are dark, I see it all so clearly. We live our lives at the mercy of the gods. Our fates are chosen for their amusement only. I beg you, remember me not as I am today. Remember a hero. Save you from the Sphinx. Remember a king who loved his family, his people, and his country. Though he was despised by the gods, he sought to rule as well as a man could. Have pity, I pray.
Enough. Take my hand. Come back to the palace.
No. Better to let me depart now. Take the children and...
Don't give me orders. Your orders have unmade you. Now, it is time for you to obey.
Then I am in your hands. Yours and the gods.
People of Thebes, you have witnessed today.
The rise and fall of King Oedipus.
He solved the riddle of the she-monster and saved us by his genius.
Rewarded with fame, with breaking with power, he was the envy of the known world.
Now, overwhelmed by disaster so great,
he will suffer until the end of his days.
People of Thebes, do not forget.
No man can be judged until his life is done.
No
one named winner till the race is run.
Call no man lucky, call no man safe, until he lies dead and asleep in his grave.